Every change is a winner. చదువులు తెలివితేటలు ఆలోచన విధానంలో నాయకత్వ లక్షణాల్లో వారు ఏ రంగంలో ముందున్నారో గుర్తించి విజేతలుగా నిలపడమే ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరిస్ ప్రత్యేకత. ఐఐటి ఎంట్రన్స్ కు సంబంధించి జేఈఈ మెయిన్స్ లో సంచలన విజయాలు సాధించిన ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరిస్ విద్యార్థులు సిహెచ్ మోహన్ కిషోర్ 99.6 తో ఉభయ గోదావరి జిల్లాలో తిరుమల కాలేజ్ టాపర్, డి దినేష్ 99.3 తో పాలకొల్లు టాపర్, టి దివ్య శ్రీలక్ష్మి 97.1, ఎన్ అనుష 96.4, ఏ ఆదిత్య 95.5. ఐఐటి టాపర్స్ తో పాటు ఏ కేటగిరీలో రంగరాయ మెడికల్ కాలేజ్ లో సీటు సాధించిన మా విద్యార్థిని ఏ కార్తీక. అంతేకాకుండా మరో 10 మెడికల్ సీట్లతో పాటు 8 మందిని చార్టర్డ్ అకౌంటెంట్స్ గా తీర్చిదిద్దింది ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరిస్. పాలకొల్లు పట్టణంలో ఉన్నత విద్యతో పాటు భవిష్యత్తులో బాగా సెటిల్ అవుతున్న వారిలో అత్యధికులు ఉల్లంపర్రు మాంటిసోరిస్ విద్యార్థులే. మీరే గమనించండి, సరైన నిర్ణయం తీసుకోండి. అడ్మిషన్ల కొరకు సంప్రదించండి మాంటిసోరిస్ విద్యా సంస్థలు ఉల్లంపర్రు. ఫోన్ 222206. బ్రాంచెస్ రామారావుపేట ఫోన్ 224200, కొడిగట్టు ఫోన్ 228800.
I started topic, the topic name is mitotic division, and the second one is meiotic division. In last classes or previous classes, we complete the cell cycle, what is mitosis, what is meiosis, and what is the significance of mitosis, what is the significance of meiosis. If there is no mitosis occur in organisms, what happened in that particular organism, and if there is no occur in meiosis in cells, what will happen in that organism. We learnt in previous classes in those topics, and today we start the division of mitosis and including the interphase, and we learnt we already learnt this important words, but we remember this because of these important words very important, very continue in this class also. What is allosomes, what is autosomes, and what is DNA, what are the characteristics and what are the properties or what are the significance of the DNA, and what is chromosomes, what are the properties of chromosomes, we are learnt in now this class also. What is a DNA? DNA is a genetic material. DNA is a genetic material, and recombinations occur in genetic material. What is recombination? Recombination means a person, you know that you are a, tells you, you are a, like you are, same like your father and same like your mother, tells like that. What will happen that? Genetic recombination. What is the meaning of genetic recombination? The characters are transferred from one generation to another generation through the crossing over is known as genetic recombination. Genetic recombinations occur in the place of DNA, the place of DNA. And now important word is chromosomes. What is chromosomes? The condensed form of chromatin is known as chromosomes. This is also learned in our previous class. The condensed form of chromatin is known as chromosomes, and this is also very important, and this is directly involved in the process of cell division. And the structure of chromosome is like this. The structure of chromosome is like this. And this is the chromosomes contains a four arms. These four arms is known as a chromatids, and this is attached by the ball like structure. This is known as a centromere. Centromere. And this will appear in the neatly and very perfectly in the process of mitosis division and in the process of meiotic division. Before mitotic and meiotic division, this is appears like a chromatin layer. These are known as chromatids. These are known as chromatids. And next important structure is a nucleus. Nucleus. And nucleus is also directly involved in the process of cell cycle. And nucleus contains the nuclear material is known as chromatin, and chromatin condenses into form a chromosomes. Chromatin condenses into form a chromosomes. Chromosomes contains a DNA material, and DNA will pass the characters from one generation to another generation. And what is autosomes? What is allosomes? Autosomes means we learned in previous classes. What is autosomes means these are in the structure of or the cell of vegetative cells or somatic cells. What is somatic cells? Somatic cells are known except gonads or except sex cells is known as autosomes. Autosomes occurs in total parts of the body like our hand, our head, our neck, our body parts, our legs like that. And these contains also two end in stays, that means diploid stays. And this will occur in total body organs except gonads. Next, what is allosomes? Allosomes are occur in gonads. Gonads means sex cells. What is the meaning of sex cells? Where it was occurring? It was occurring in the testis and also ovary. Allosomes are occurring in testis and ovary. And now we are entering into cell division again, because it is very important process and it is continuous process for mitosis. And we know the information again, we will recall the information again, cell division. What is cell division? Including both. What including both? Including interphase and including mitotic division is known as a cell division. And this is the process of cell cycle, total process of cell cycle. In interphase, this is interphase. The interphase including three subfaces. The interphase including three subfaces, they are G1, S, G2. G1 phase is known as cell growth phase. That means cell grow in size is known as G1 phase. And S phase, what is the meaning of S phase? S phase means DNA synthesis. We learned in previous classes, but I will recall the information again. It is very important if it is continued to mitotic process. That's why we call recall the information again. What is DNA synthesis? DNA synthesis means to make the DNA. Synthesis means making. DNA synthesis, and that means produce or duplicate the or replicate the DNA. Replicate the DNA is known as DNA synthesis. And again G2 phase. In this G2 phase is same as G1 phase. That means cell grow in size or gamma phase again start here, G2 phase. And this is known as cell grow in size phase or cell growth phase. This is known as gap 2 phase. And now start a mitotic division. What is mitosis? Mitosis means cell divide into form a new individuals is known as mitotic phase. Where it was occur in mitotic phase? Mitotic phase is occur in the somatic cells or vegetative cells. What is somatic cells? We already learned. Somatic cells means except gonad cells is known as somatic cells. That means mitotic division is a continuous process in prokaryotic and eukaryotic organisms. In mitotic division, the cell division starts from the 2S stage of cell. That means a diploid cell. Mitosis start with the 2N stage of cell. Here is a mitosis division. In complete of interphase, the cell directly goes into the mitotic division. Here is a mitotic division. What is mitotic division? Include both. That means karyokinesis and cytokinesis. Include both. Karyokinesis and cytokinesis is in the phase of mitotic division. What is karyokinesis? Karyokinesis means the splitting occurring nucleus is known as karyokinesis. Where it was occurring in mitotic phase? What is the karyokinesis? What are the processes? What are the phases involved in karyokinesis? These are the phases here: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. These are the phases. prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, or place in the karyokinesis. Karyokinesis means to splitting or to division of the nucleus. To division of the nucleus is known as karyokinesis. Okay. Now interphase is complete totally. Interphase is complete totally. In interphase, DNA synthesis or do DNA replicate or prepare the cell. A typical eukaryotic cell prepare itself in the process of mitosis is known as interphase. If interphase is complete now, the cell directly goes into the karyokinesis. The phases of prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. And now the cell directly goes into cytokinesis. What is the meaning of cytokinesis? Cyto means a cell. Cyto means a cell. Kinesis means to split. To split or to breaking down of new individuals from the one mother cell is known as cytokinesis. And that means kinesis or to break. Kinesis or to break occur in the cell is known as cytokinesis. In the process of cytokinesis, the total mother cell can give space to two individuals, two baby cells, two young ones. That is known as cytokinesis. And next, we already learned in previous class, mitosis is a continuous process in prokaryotic and eukaryotic organisms. In continuous process means, if complete the cytokinesis, the cell directly enters into a interphase. The cell directly enters into a interphase and then goes to prophase and then goes to metaphase and then goes to anaphase and then goes to telophase. And next cytokinesis and next goes to interphase. This is the total stages of mitosis in prokaryotic and eukaryotic organisms. In prokaryotic organisms, mitosis is a very important. Total process is occurring only mitotic division. Total body functions are depends upon the mitotic division, because there is no particular organelles. There is no particular organelles or organs in their body. That's why there is no meiotic divisions. There only mitotic divisions occur in the organisms of prokaryotic organisms. Now recall the information about mitosis. Mitosis is a cell division. The cell divides into forming new individuals is known as mitosis. Mitosis starts from the process of karyokinesis. In the karyokinesis, the first phase of karyokinesis is prophase. Prophase means pro means a pre. That means a starting phase of karyokinesis is known as a prophase. In the prophase, the chromosomes or chromatids condense into form a chromosomes. Chromosomes is a very short in structure. Very short in structure. They are visible even in a compound or a light or a simple microscope. And here is information about the prophase. Pro means pre. Pre means a starting phase of karyokinesis is known as a prophase. In this prophase, chromosomes are contract. Chromosomes are contract and become spiral in shape. And now even in the they are visible even in a light or compound microscope, and nuclei become smaller. Why the nuclei become smaller? There is no use of nucleus. Why there is no use of nucleus? Because it is the process of replication and the process of duplication, and also the process of synthesis is also over. So there is no importance of nuclei here. That's why nuclei become smaller. And the next process of prophase is chromosomes are split to here. Before the prophase, chromosomes are here like this. The formation is here like this. And enter into the prophase and the chromosomes are split into form a chromatids. The arms are split into form a four arms. They are known as chromatids. chromatids. That means the chromosomes lengthwise to form chromatids. And the last important point is nuclear membrane disappear. Nuclear membrane disappear. Why the nuclear membrane disappear? The chromosomes enter into the cytoplasm through the process of mitotic division. That's why nuclear membrane disappears here. And last important point is every organism cell or every animal cell contains a centrosomes. This is one of the organelle of the animal cell. The centrosomes contains a here centrosome. The centrosomes contains a centriole. A rod-like structures is known as centrioles. These centrioles divides into form a thread-like or pore-like structures is known as a spindle fibers. And these spindle fibers are formed on each opposite side of the cell here like this. Each opposite side of the cell here. These are known as centrosomes and these are known as spindle fibers. These are known as centrosomes and these are known as spindle fibers. Each are formed to opposite poles of the cell. This is known as opposite pole of the cell. And each side of each centrovia is activated and form both sides of spindle fibers. This spindle fibers helps in the process of mitotic division to split the chromosomes to pull the opposite poles to chromosomes. This is total prophase or prephase. This is the starting phase of mitotic and including the division of first division of karyokinesis. Now the cell enter into the phase of metaphase. What happened in the prophase? In the prophase, spindle fibers are formed from the centrosome and we denoted that these are chromosomes and we identified the chromosomes and the chromosomes contains a four chromatids in the prophase. Pro means a pre. That means a first starting phase is known as a prephase. In metaphase, chromosomes move to equatorial plate. This plate, that means we imagine that this is the plate that is known as an equatorial plate. In the equatorial plate, the chromosomes are attached by the spindle fibers. The plate is known as equatorial plate. This is known as spindle fibers. These spindle fibers are formed from the organelle is known as centrosomes. We learned in that class. Okay. Now attached to the chromosomes here, see a equatorial plate by a centromere, and by a spindle fiber. These are known as spindle fiber, and this is known as equatorial plate. And chromosomes contains a four chromatids. What is the meaning of metaphase? Metaphase means middle. The middle phase is known as metaphase. Now the points of the metaphase is chromosomes moves to spindle fiber. Chromosomes moves to spindle equator. Centromeres attached to spindle fibers. And centromeres split and separating the chromosomes too. This is the total process of metaphase. The middle phase is known as metaphase. In the next phase of metaphase is known as anaphase. What is the meaning of anaphase? A opposite phase. Ana means opposite. Here, this is the anaphase. Anaphase means spindle fibers attached to chromosomes contract and pulling chromatids towards two poles is known as a total anaphase. What is the process occurring anaphase? In the process of anaphase is centromeres are pulled by using the spindle fibers. And the chromosomes have a, in this process of anaphase, the chromosomes has a two chromatids. You see here, the chromosomes has a two chromatids because of the pulling of centromere occur here, and by using of spindle fibers, and the chromosomes goes to opposite poles. You see here direction. See here direction. The chromosomes goes to opposite poles, and pulling chromosomes, chromatids towards to poles. What is the meaning of anaphase? The opposite. That means the chromosomes goes to each opposite side. That is known as anaphase. And next telophase. What is the last phase? In the phase of karyokinesis, this is the last phase. Last phase. The last phase is known as a telophase. Teloph means last, and the reversible process occur in the prophase. This is the reversible process of prophase. This is the reversible process of prophase. In telophase, this is the last phase. Chromosomes elongate and become. This is not visible even in a compound or a light microscope. They are visible in only electron microscope, and they form a thread-like structures. That is known as a chromatin layer. And nuclear membrane form and bound the nucleus. And cell membrane, and next cell membrane and pinches into form a and bound the cell. And next nucleus divide into two through the formation of nuclear membrane. And next cytoplasm starts. In mitotic division, there is a two subphases. The first one is a karyokinesis is over, and now start a cytoplasm. In cytoplasm, the cell splitting into form a new individuals and form a cell wall is known as cytoplasm. What is this? Is form a cytoplasm. That means in cytokinesis, completed the cytokinesis, there is a every daughter cell contains a two nucleus and bounded by nuclear membrane and bounded by a well-known chromosomes and a well-known centromeres and nucleosomes and well-known nuclear membrane and well-known a new wall, cell wall. This total process is occur in cytokinesis. Till the end of the telophase, a cytoplasm start the division of cytokinesis. In the end of the cytokinesis, a new individual or new daughter cells are formed. In the phase of mitotic division, the mother cell, in the starting of mitotic division, the mother cell contains a two set of chromosomes, and also the daughter chromosomes contains a two set of chromosomes, or the cell is in a diploid stage, and this is occur in somatic cells. That means total body organs. And what is the significance of the mitosis? And now, before going to significance, what are the steps? The first step is karyokinesis, and second step is cytokinesis. In a karyokinesis, prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. In cytokinesis, the cytoplasm divides into form a new individuals, and this is occur in somatic cells. The somatic cells contain a two end stage, that means a diploid stage. Each and every division of the mitotic cell division, there is a two cells are formed. One division occurs in a cell, and one time of nucleus division in a cell division, two cells are formed. The two cells have a two ending stage in a chromosomes. And what is the significance of the mitosis? The significance of the mitosis, they replace the new cells in the place of old cells, and also the cell grow in size. That means a growing of body organs like body parts like hands and legs and neck and face, etc. And also this will helps in the growth or development of the baby, from baby to young one, or 20 years adult.
Mitosis is a process of nuclear division by which replicated copies of a cell's DNA are organized into chromosomes. The identical copies of the DNA are then divided equally between two daughter cells. Early in mitosis, during prophase, the nuclear membrane and nucleolus begin to break down. As prophase continues, the DNA condenses to form chromosomes, while the mitotic spindle, made of proteins called microtubules, begins to form and attaches to the kinetochores on each chromosome. During metaphase, the chromosomes are moved to the central plate of the cell by the spindle microtubules. In anaphase, the microtubules attached to the kinetochores of each chromosome shorten, drawing the chromatids of each chromosome to opposite ends of the cell, while the unattached microtubules elongate, stretching the cell. During telophase, the chromatids, now called chromosomes, reach the poles of the cell as the unattached microtubules continue to elongate. The nuclear membranes begin to reform as the nucleoli reappear and the chromosomes relax as the DNA unwinds. Telophase is followed by cytokinesis, or division of the cytoplasm. In animal cells, a cleavage furrow forms at the center on either side of the cell, pinching through until the original cell is divided into two daughter cells. In plant cells, cytokinesis is different due to the presence of a rigid cell wall.
In the cells occurring two types of divisions, the first one is mitosis and second one is meiosis. The mitosis is occurring somatic cells and meiosis occurring sex cells. What is the meaning of sex cells? Where it occurs? The sex cells occur in testis and also ovary. And the process of meiosis is the occur or place in only reproduction, the phase of sexual reproduction and the formation of gametes like ovary or ovum and also sperms. And this is also known as a reduction division. Why this is known as reduction division? The chromosomes, by splitting into half as well as are as comparative of mother cell. By starting the meiosis, the cell enter into the meiotic division. The cell contain a two set of chromosomes. That means the cell has a diploid in stage. Here, see here. For example, this is the parent cell of the starting parent cell of meiosis. The starting parent cell contains a two set of chromosomes. In two set of chromosomes divide into form a two daughter cells. And two daughter cells has a n set of chromosomes by the process of reduction division. What is the meaning of process of reduction division? By reducing to half of the chromosome as well as the mother cell is known as reduction division. This is occurring sex cells, and in the process of meiotic division, there is two subphases. The first phase is meiosis 1 and second phase is meiosis 2. In the process of meiosis 1, there is a genetic recombinations occur through the process of crossing over. I already learnt in previous classes what is genetic recombination. Some people are told to you already, you are like a mother, you are like your father, you are like your sister, you are like your grandfather, you are like your grandmother tells like that. That is a genetic recombinations. Genetic recombinations are not there in the process of, if genetic recombinations are not there in the process of meiosis, you are your carbon copy of your brother. Are your carbon copy of your neighbor. And also, if there is no genetic recombinations, a crossing power is not occur in the process of meiosis, there will be a multiplication of chromosomal number. That means in the next generation or future generations, 16 and set of chromosomes are formed. It may be creatures or different organisms are formed. If there is no meiosis occur in the chromosomes. And now there is a two surfaces in meiosis. The first surface is a meiosis 1 and second surface is a meiosis 2. In the meiosis 1 contains a four surfaces. They are prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1, as well as follows a cytokinesis 1. And in the process of meiosis 2, prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2, telophase 2 and follows a cytokinesis 2. This is the same as well as a mitotic division. This is same as mitotic division. And that means this is the total process in comparatively same mitotic division. But this is not. The chromosomes, the replication of chromosomes occurs here. The mitotic meiotic division 1. The chromosomes replication or duplication or DNA replication is occurs here. And genetic recombinations occurs here. And the process of crossing over is also occur here. And also the chromosomes reduction process or division process is also occur here. And now this is the mother cell of the meiotic division. In mother cell of meiotic division, or the participate of the mother cell contains a 2n set of chromosomes. 2n set of chromosomes. That means this is a diploid in stage. And the in meiotic division 1, there is a 2 cells are formed. The two cells contains a n set of chromosomes. That means the reduction division also over in the meiotic division 1. And in the next, here n set of, these cells contains a n set of chromosomes. Here is the mother of the meiotic division 2. A mother cell of the meiotic division 2. In meiotic division 2, there is a four daughter cells are formed from the meiotic division 1 parents. Here, this is the total division of the meiosis. Meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. In meiosis 1, genetic recombinations occur and the cell divides twice and chromosomes divides once, nucleus divides once and cell divides twice and duplication and also replication occur here, genetic recombinations and crossing power also occur here and n set of chromosomes also formed here and two daughter cells also formed here. And this is the total process of meiosis. This is meiosis 1 and this is meiosis 2. And this is occurs in sex cells in the formation, in the process of sexual reproduction.
In prophase 1, the DNA coils tightly and individual chromosomes become visible under the light microscope. Homologous chromosomes become closely associated in synapses and they exchange segments by crossing over. By metaphase 1, the nuclear membrane has disappeared and the microtubules form a spindle. Spindle fibers attach to only one side of each centromere and the two homologous chromosomes attach to microtubules orienting from opposite poles. Each pair of homologs then lines up on the metaphase plate. Either maternal or paternal homolog may orient toward a given pole. In anaphase 1, the microtubules of the spindle fiber shorten and pull the chromosomes toward the poles, taking both sister chromatids with them. Each pole ends up with a complete haploid set of chromosomes consisting of one member of the homologous pair. During telophase 1, the nuclear membrane reforms around the daughter nuclei. Each daughter nucleus contains two sister chromatids for each chromosome attached to a common centromere. Because of crossing over, the two sister chromatids are not identical. During prophase 2, the nuclear envelope breaks down and a new spindle forms. In metaphase 2, spindle fibers bind to both sides of the centromeres. During anaphase 2, the spindle fibers contract and the sister chromatids move toward opposite poles. In telophase 2, nuclear envelopes reform around the sets of daughter chromosomes.
Now the process at the session of cell cycle and the division of mitosis and meiosis is over. You know, this is very important topic in our next public examinations. Please read well. Thank you very much.
Ullampur Manchu School, and DC class, and IIT class, సమర్థవంతంగా నిర్వహిస్తున్నారు. ఈ స్కూల్ నుండి 10 మంది డాక్టర్లు, 8 మంది చార్టర్డ్ అకౌంటెంట్లు, అనేక మంది ఐఐటి ఎన్ఐటిలో చదివిన ఇంజనీర్లు ఉన్నారు. అంతేకాదు ఈ విద్యా సంస్థల్లో 10 రకాల కాంపిటేషన్ ఎగ్జామ్స్లోని విజయకేతలు ఎగరేశారు. 4 స్టేట్ ఫస్ట్లు, 40 టాప్ 10 ర్యాంకులతో పాటు 13 మంది గోల్డ్ మెడల్ సాధించారు. ఒత్తిడి లేని విద్యను అందిస్తూ అటు జాతీయ స్థాయి స్పోర్ట్స్ ర్యాంకులతో పాటు ఇది ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ర్యాంకులు సాధిస్తున్న ఏకైక విద్యా సంస్థ ఉల్లంపూర్ మాంటిసోరి స్కూల్.